Good afternoon, dear my students. Today, in this lecture, I will explain an approximation method to find approximate value of a root of a function. This method is called regula falsi method. This is an approximation method to find an approximate values of the root of a function. Okay, let's see the subject. Okay, this method is specification of the second method. Okay, you know from our previous lectures we had learned second method. This method is specification of the second method, and algorithm is similar to bisection method. Because yes, before let's recall previous lectures, we had learned three approximation methods to find root of a function. In this subject, we consider we have a function, we have a continuous function f of x, and we need to find approximate value of the root of this function, and we suppose that this function has a root like that. We suppose that graph of the function like that. This function has a root, alpha, the number alpha is the exact solution of this equation, such that f of alpha equals zero. Okay, so alpha is exact solution of this equation. We need to find approximate values of the alpha using approximation methods. We had learned four approximation methods. First one is bisection method. Second approximation method is Newton-Raphson method, we had learned before, okay? And three method was secant method, okay? We had learned before. Today, finally, we will learn regular falsi method is the final subject in this chapter. Okay, regular falsi method. All these methods enable us to find approximate values of the root of the function. Okay, let's see the algorithm of the method. In this method, we consider we have two initial approximation guesses. First one is x0. Second one is x1. x0 and x1 initial approximation guesses, such that f of x0 times f of x1 less than 0. According to the figure, f of x0 is positive number. F of x0 is positive number, and f of x1 is negative number. Okay, f of x1 negative one number. So according to this rule, this function has a root. This is exact solution of the equation. We consider f of x equals zero, and we need to find approximate values of the alpha. Okay, alpha is exact solution, which means that f of alpha equals zero. Okay, to find approximate values of the root of the alpha, first of all, we need to choose two initial guesses. X0 and X1 are our two initial guesses, okay? Such that this condition is satisfied, okay? And if you find the secant line, equation of the secant line, this secant line crosses the x-axis at the next iteration. X2 is next iteration of the method. Okay, in that case, again, we can if we sketch this secant line. Okay, in that case, this point will be next iteration, x3. Okay, and so on. If you sketch this secant line, we will get next iteration x4. Okay, this is the general formula. This is the general formula of the regular Falsi method. This formula comes from the secant line. If you find equation of the secant line using this formula, for example, if you write like an equation y minus y0 equals slope times slope denoted by m, m is slope of the secant line, slope times x minus x0. Okay, x0 is initial iteration, y0 is value of the function at the x0, y0 is value of the function at the x0. If you find this equation, and then to get x2, we need to substitute 0 for y. In that case, if you solve this equation, this number will be next iteration. X, in that case, x equals this formula. Okay, do you understand? Yes. Let's see the algorithm of the method. In the first step of the algorithm, we need to guess two initial guesses. Okay, x sub a and x sub b are our initial guesses. Okay, and for which f of x sub a times f of x sub b must be less than zero. In that case, this function has a root between xa and xb. Okay, to find next iteration, xc is next iteration. Okay, this is next iteration of the root, next iteration. Okay, applying this formula, we will get the number x sub c. Okay, x sub c is next iteration, current iteration. Okay, and then you need to evaluate approximation error. Formula for approximation error like this. In this formula, epsilon a is called approximation error, relative approximation error. Okay, and in this formula, x nil is current estimate of root, current estimation, and x alt is previous estimation. Okay, using this formula, we can evaluate approximation error for each iteration. Okay, then we need to decide where is the root, because we start from, suppose that this is real line. Okay, this is real line, x a and x b are initial guesses, and applying method we get the number xc. Xc must be between xa and xb. Okay, and now we need to decide where the function go, function passing where, like that or like that. Okay, root exact solution, where is the exact solution? Alpha, I don't know. Applying this rule, if this is true, then zero or root lies in this interval. Okay, if this condition is true, this means that zero lies in this interval. Zero in this interval. Okay. If this is true, we need to set like a relation, x sub a must be equal to x sub a, and x sub b must be equal to xc, if first condition is true. If second condition is true, f of x a times f of xc greater than xc greater than zero, this condition means that zero lies in this interval. Okay, zero lies in this interval. So if this is true, we need to set x a equals x c. We need to set this must be x a. Okay, this must be x b. Okay, this number must be x b. So we need to set like this and like this. Okay, if this one is true, f of xc equals to zero, so in that case, xc is true solution. Okay, xc is true solution. Applying these three conditions, we can decide zero lies where. Okay, zero lies where. Okay, next step is like that. If approximation error is greater than error tolerance, epsilon s is error tolerance, this is given number. Okay, error tolerance will be given. If approximation error greater than error tolerance, if this is true, so we need to go step one to evaluate next iteration. Okay, if this is not true, this means that approximation error less than or equal to error tolerance. If this is true, we need to stop the algorithm. Okay, we need to stop the algorithm, and final iteration will be our approximate solution. Okay, yes, let's continue. In this example, we will simulate the method. In this example, we suppose that the floating ball has a specific gravity of 0.6 and has a radius of 5.5 centimeters. We are asked to find the depth to which the ball is submerged when floating in the water. We need to find x. We need to find this number. This number shows us the this ball. This ball is in the water. Okay, x shows the length of the part of the ball. Okay. Yes, let's continue. This function shows the depth of ball. Okay, f of x equals this function, and we need to find root of this function. If you solve this equation, we will get the x. Okay, x is depth of the ball. Okay, yes, let's apply Regular-False method to find approximate value. Okay, the red line shows us graph of the function. Red line is graph of the function. This function is given. Okay, and we need to find approximate values of the exact value. Exact value is alpha. Okay, f of alpha equals zero, but we don't know what is alpha. We don't know. Okay. Yes. First of all, we need to choose two initial guesses. Okay. We know that x must be in this interval. Okay. This interval comes from this. X must be greater than zero, less than or equal to 2r. R is radius of the ball. Okay, r is given. R is given. 5. R is given. Okay, like that. This is r, capital R. Okay, this is radius of the ball, and according to this knowledge, we can suppose that x must be in this interval. Okay, so 0 will be first iteration, and this number 0.11 will be second iteration of the method. Okay, x0 equals 0, x1 equals 0.11. okay, and if you suppose that x sub a equals 0, x sub b equals 0.11, in the first iteration we can evaluate xc using this formula. Okay, this is the general formula of the Regular-False method. Okay, in this formula xa is left boundary point of the interval, xb is right boundary point, like that. Okay, this is real line, xa left initial guess, xb is right initial guess. Okay, xa equals 0, xb equals 0.11. okay, we need to find xc. Xc can be obtained using this formula. If you apply this formula, you will get this number as xc. Okay, in that case xc must be this number, 0.066. this is the next iteration of the algorithm. Okay, now we need to find approximation error. Okay, and our current estimation of the root like this, like that, and this is can be considered as old iteration. Okay, x old equals 0, or you can consider x old equals xb. okay, this is x sub a, and x old can be considered as xb. okay, if you apply this formula to get approximation error, in that case we will get this. This is very big error. Okay, so this error says us we need to continue the process. Okay, Yes, let's continue the process. In the next iteration, now left boundary point is this, and second boundary point is this, okay? For which f of xa times f of xb less than 0, okay? This is true. We suppose we can show that this is true. So xa equals 0, xb is this. And if you apply formula of the method using considering these numbers, in that case xc will be this number, okay? Xc will be this number, okay? Like that. This is xa, xa equals 0. This is xb, xb equals 0.11. After first iteration, we will get this point, xc. Xc equals 0.06, I think, okay? 0.066, okay? 0.066. And we suppose that this is true, and apply the method again, and we will get this number, okay? This number like that, okay? 0.0611, okay? This is new estimation of the root, okay? And again, we need to evaluate approximation error using these numbers, okay? In that case, our new estimation will be this number, and old estimation is this, okay? Old estimation will be not this, will be this, 0.066, okay? Yes, if you evaluate approximation error, we will get 8%. 8% is not enough for me, so we need to continue the process. And again, in iteration 3, we need to find new estimation using this formula, okay? In that case, xa equals 0, xb equals this number, okay? If you apply the formula, you will get this number for new estimation, okay? This is our new estimation of the root, okay? Again, we need to evaluate approximation error. Approximation error can be obtained using this formula. In that case, error will be 2.05%, okay? And it is not enough, so we need to continue for next iteration, okay? In the iteration 4, we consider these numbers, okay? For which, again, f of xa times f of xb less than 0. We can show that this is true. You can show that easily. This is true, okay? F of xa times f of xb less than 0. So we can evaluate next estimation using same formula, okay? And then the new estimation will be like that, okay? 0.06237 is our new estimation, okay? And again, we need to evaluate approximation error. Approximation error will be evaluated in each step. Okay. In that case, this is new estimation. This is old estimation. Okay. And if you apply this formula, in that case, approximation error will be this number. Okay. This is very, very small number. Okay. And this is enough for us. And so we need to stop the process, okay? In that case, x nil will be our solution. This is solution, okay? Solution of the problem. Problem is this, f of x equals 0, okay? And you can check that f of x nil is very small number, absolute value of this, very close to 0, you can check, okay? Yes, now I would like to talk about advantages and disadvantages of this method, okay? Advantages of this method is this method converges fast if it converges, okay? This method converges fast if it converges, okay? And disadvantage of this method is this method requires two guesses. This method requires two guesses and two guesses that need to bracket to the root, okay? Like that. We suppose that function, graph of function like this, this is f of x, okay? We need to require two guesses like that. This is first guesses, x0. This is two guesses, x1. And this must be true. F of x0 times f of x1 must be less than 0, okay? In that case, this function has a root between this interval, okay? This function has a root in this interval. x0, x1 contains the zero of the function, okay? If this is true. Okay. Yes, this is the drawbacks of the method. This method requires two guesses. And yes, this is the MATLAB code of the method. Applying this code, if you run this code in the MATLAB program, you will get the approximate solution easily. If you apply this code, please copy paste this code for your MATLAB program. If you run this code, you will get this. You will get approximate values of the function fast. You will get easily. Okay. Yes. In this lecture, we explained the regular function method. Okay. I hope you understand the method. If you have any further questions, you can ask me using sticks, okay? I wish you have a healthy days and see you next lecture, okay?